Hi guys, it's Addie Tice with Riverbend Nature Center, and I'm here today at Minnesota's third oldest state park, Minneopa State Park. It's home to a newly established population of American Plains bison, and it's found just right outside the city of Mankato. The park has both natural and historic features, including southern Minnesota's tallest waterfall, so you could spend the whole day exploring here. For first timers, just be aware the park is in two different units. There's the park, the fall side, and the bison side. So I hope you join me as we explore one of my favorite parks here at Minneopa. We're going to start our tour on the fall side of the park, and we get a glimpse of the first set of falls on Minneopa Creek. The word Minneopa is derived from the Dakota language and is interpreted to mean water falling twice, referring to the beautiful waterfalls of Minneopa Creek that is one of the main attractions of the park. You can walk down the trail which encircles the falls and leads down to a limestone stairway to the valley below. You can get an up and close encounter with the waterfall if you continue down the trail, but be advised that swimming is prohibited in Minneopa Creek. Minneopa is also known for their picnic grounds, so bring a packed lunch when you travel here. Now let's go to the bison side of the park.
We're now entering the bison range, where we can drive through the enclosure to view the bison. The green grates on the road allow us to enter but keep the bison inside their enclosure. Inside the enclosure, please remain in your vehicle. The Minnesota DNR and the Minnesota Zoo work together to manage a bison herd with high quality genetics, which allows for the continuous preservation of the American Plains bison with healthy genetics and can help us conserve other prairie wildlife species native to Minnesota. Keep a watchful eye as you drive through the range and take advantage of the Seepman Mill overlook to help spot them. That's where I am right now, and it helps me get a different view of them. You also get a beautiful panoramic view of the Minnesota River Valley from this hill. The bison are free to roam 331 acres of prairie, so sometimes it might be difficult to spot them, but there is a hiking trail that does loop around the entire enclosure. So that might be an easier way to spot them than from your car through the range. Bison can be dangerous animals, especially when calves are present, like in the springtime. Always give bison clearance of at least 75 feet. Take a look at the Seepman Windmill, built by Lewis Seepman in 1864 and was made mostly of stone. The native German could grind about 150 bushels of wheat into flour on a favorable wind day. The windmill was struck by a natural calamity, including lightning and a tornado. After the tornado struck in 1890, the arms of the windmill were not fixed due to unprofitability.
The top picture shows what the windmill would have looked like in full operation.
In 1905, the state of Minnesota passed legislation setting aside the area around Minneopa Falls for public use and establishing the state park. This made Minneopa the third state park in Minnesota. The first was Itasca in 1891 and Interstate in 1895. The falls were well known, and it became a popular destination for thousands of visitors who came by rail to the town site of Minneopa, which had sprung up around the adjacent depot in 1870.